here comes the puzzle piece. I want to elaborate a bit about what you interact with when you work with your consciousness using algoriswo as example. I am a foreigner and I am not religious, even though I'm not atheist either. So I am not sure how to call it. That's why I made this video, so that you understand what, at least part of what I am referring to. Let's for now call it super consciousness. If you are spiritual, that will be helpful. If you are atheist, then a server might be another option. I really like the server because it really covers pretty much exactly what it works like. What also helped me in the past, the interpretation of it was that it's like future you. And I probably will talk about it a bit later. So basically what we are talking about, think about database. Each person, each of you, is living sort of a universe. I'm not talking about universe as a cosmos, but I'm talking about universe of your consciousness, of your mind. It's especially visible when you close your eyes. You have no limit. Your consciousness is limitless. You can touch anything with a thought. I like this phrase. So adding quantum physics here, we have a lot of alternative versions of universe, your consciousness universe, which doesn't mean exactly that they coexist at the same time. It's more like a radio. You are tuned to a specific version of possibilities, which basically is kind of like implementation of what you have in your mind. We are not talking even the beliefs, because beliefs is actually more like on a physical level, it's body. Your brain has data. It has mapping. It has specific kind of mapping. It has specific information in forms of neuron connections. So on a physical level, I compare it with computer, it's like a hardware. Physical body is a hardware. It's a vehicle. But what makes it drive is software, which is your consciousness. And then there is a user, which spiritual people will probably call it the soul. I like calling it the driver because I see it. And to make a reference, some people say that don't be scared, it won't hurt real you. But that's the thing, it will, because body is connected to the mind, unless you're in coma or out of body experience or any kind of drugs. It's unhealthy ways to experience the difference when you kind of, it's not exactly separation because you're still functioning within your body, but it's very clear, it becomes very clear how your mind is really a software for your body. It's amazing. But just like with computer, the box is just a box if you don't connect it to operating system of some sort. Same with body. Coma. Anyway, so based on the condition, there you go, based on the condition of your vehicle, of your body and mind, you data collected and stored in your vehicle on a physical level through mind and etc. Through body, I mean brain. Based on this, you experience the everything around you, reality. Right? Common word used. So if you look at yourself, if you're spiritual, then in a way it's like God, it's a foreign word for me. I don't use it much, but I mean, it's part of language. Like, it's like wherever you can put nature, maybe life, whichever lingo you use, it is experiencing the world through you, through your vehicle. So in a way, you are a piece of God. I discovered the other day these amazing terms in Hinduism, I think. It's Atman and the Brahmin. Brahmin is the absolute reality or something, you can Google it. And Atman is like a drop of the ocean. So you are essentially a drop of the ocean, which I'm giving you information, that's why it's a puzzle piece. I am telling how I see it. You apply it the way you see it. So I'm just giving you information and you take what you what is usable to you. And back to my point, as a collector, data collector, in a way that is experiencing specific station as a radio, as I said, out of all the alternative universes of your mind, all of this is collected because it would be a waste. Think you are a unique human, absolutely unique, no one like you. And even if you're atheist, obviously some kind of use of data gotta be, it cannot just go to waste. So think about that. This is just one of experiences that you lively collect. Then through thought, if you think linearly, time speaking, from the beginning to of your life to the end, from each point, there are tons of alternatives that you haven't experienced and won't, because you can experience only one, you have just one vehicle. So you see, it's an iteration in a way. You have one person, and then from each point, it's tons of little, alternatives. So now think about all the people that also coexist at this specific moment with you and coexisted at others times. Each of the person is iteration. So all of this data is gathered. And in a way, mathematically speaking, it's a summation. So this sum of all the knowledge, this database, is exactly what you are referring to. Except out of all of this database, let's talk about prayer. See, like when people pray, which I don't, because I don't see the point. Why? When people pray, it's like this thing, God, it's huge something. Most of the time, it's authority-like, it's punisher, it's almighty, it's like, as a human, we are, I like Danny Boy, my favorite comedian, he has this hilarious bit, God is great and we are shit. But that's the thing, we, through life, we gathered this information and we believe that we are indeed piece of shit and the God Almighty is someone who will punish us for being bad. But that's the thing, if you clear, because all of this is just data on the physical level, if you clear all of this, and that's why I use the tool, it specifically for purposes like this, then you realize that every human is big. Why are you living? It's not for some mere survival. You, every single person has this incredible, call it potential, whichever, because as I said earlier, it would be a waste otherwise. So when people pray, they pray from this point of small something, small ant, who is hoping that someone there will hurt. It's like knocking on the door and not even knowing if anyone is there most of the time, or kind of believing. That's why it's belief, faith. What is it? Anyway, but that's the thing, that if you think about it as this big database, or big ocean, as I said, and you are a drop of the ocean, which if you look at the microscope, in the microscope, you will see that ocean is exactly the same as a drop. I mean, it's just different size, but the chemical content is the same. That's what I mean, a piece of God, even though I don't like the word. So think about that on this server, this database, with all this information about every human being ever existing to be and in the past, out of there, in all of this information, there is a specific folder for you, which has all the information that you need. And it has information such as what should I do in order to survive wherever I'm experiencing now? Or what is not letting me see the true meaning of something? Or what is the reason of what I'm having right now? And see, unlike the prayer, which I said, knocking on the door, and like server, you send request and you get exact answer back. It's an interaction. And there are some trickeries, which I will not be covering in this video, but because the thing is that that's why I don't like the word God, because in most cases, most of these deities, it's what they call a egregor, Google it, which as every single piece of information you're having, it's all important, because otherwise you wouldn't hear it. So even these gods, Allah and everything, each of that contains information that's very valuable. But because we experience the world through body, thus we have very specific and individualized, and most of the time buggy, I call it, we have obstacles. It's like if you are on the first floor, you can't see high because you have all of these buildings. But if you move higher, then you really, the higher you move, the more you see. And what keeps you down is exactly the pretty much weight of everything you've gathered in your life. I see it as when you are born, you have clear mind, and then you begin experiencing, and all the information you gather, it's kind of like folders. So you have folder for betrayal, folder for morality. But if you clear that, you will realize something unique to you that will allow, get higher, you can see more. And it's a lot of science, and that's, it's not just blah blah. And it's not esoteric stuff, which is special meaning just for special group of people. No, it's available to everyone. I mean, it's not even that. Everyone is seeing the world legitly. What you believe in is legit. No one else knows better, because everyone is having their own experience. That's why yours is unique and so important. And I got off the track. Of course I did, because I always do. But that's why I like, one of the options that kind of came to me, because I'm a foreigner, I don't know how to call it in English. That's why I actually made the algoriswo. Because, and I was thinking how to call it, and I mentioned earlier, my future me sort of helps. And that's the thing, that you, as a drop of the ocean, you're asking ocean / server / database / super consciousness, collective conscious and unconscious. You're asking specific question, you get it back, and because you actually interact because you actually get answer, which is, that's why I'm not atheist. I know too much to not believe at this point of my life instantly, because I instantly saw, because you, anyway, not about that. I have so much to share. So, because you're interacting, it's life. And it's not linear, and the way, it's not even that you just get the answer, duh, everyone does. I mean, I'm sure you know. But it, you get answer which is absolutely irrelevant at first. Like, when you ask specific question and you get data from childhood, from episode which you forgot for ages, you, why, you ask back, and it's, you get a specific answer because of this, this and that, and then you fix it, you apply the answer you get, and you see the change. That's why I'm not atheist. And I mean, if you are, probably not for long. But that's the, that's why I call it future me, because it's something that has survived and it has all the information about every possible outcome, all the alternative quantum physics. And I ask, give me the one that's the most beneficial, and I get it. That's why it, I mean, it's alive, it exists, and therefore it has survived wherever I've experienced. Think about it, it's not linear. Time is just a measurement. So obviously, wherever this is, it's much more, it doesn't see, it has much more dimensions. Okay, anyway, so let me see, did I cover everything? I think so. Yep, looks like it. Okay, cool. Yeah, so to sum up, I mean, database summation of all the knowledge you connect to folder that belongs to you. And that's it. I think, yeah. So have a good life. Hopefully this works.